Hi folks, my name is Nate Webster. I'm the chair of the Haverhill Cultural Council, and I'd like to welcome you here to the Multicultural Festival Haverhill 2021. Tonight we're going to be exploring cultures from all around this great city. We're going to be exploring music, dancing, interviews, cooking segments, and more. So sit back and relax. Welcome to the 2021 Multicultural Festival Haverhill Preview Night.
Haverhill is a gloriously eclectic mix of modern freshness and old world charm. Our city is home to many amazing and diverse cultures. As we become more exposed to different nationalities and customs, we're realizing that people of different cultures, they're really so much alike. Multicultural connections are needed to create coexistence and a shared interest to build a stronger community. Together, generating unity and exclusivity, the Haverhill Cultural Council is presenting the Multicultural Festival virtually during the month of September 2021. This is a celebration of life and its different experiences and expressions. It is the first of what we hope will be an annual event and another incredible opportunity to experience Haverhill all at its best.
We want to acknowledge that Haverhill is located on the traditional lands of the Penacook, Pentucket, Pawtucket, Abenaki, and Wabanaki Confederacy. These tribal nations who inhabited this territory for thousands of years have lasting connections to and stewardship of the unceded lands and waterways. These nations were also among the earliest inhabitants that the English invaders first encountered. Since the invasion, indigenous peoples have endured a painful history of genocide, colonization, and historical misinformation. But they survive and flourish today, as is evident by their descendants.
On this episode of the Multicultural Festival, we have music from a local favorite, EJ Ouellette and Crazy Maggy, as well as Triana from Triana's Real Mexican Food, where she'll be showing us how to make frijole charros.
Hi, welcome to the Multicultural Festival of Haverhill, Massachusetts. My name is EJ Ouellette, and I'm with the band Crazy Maggy. And we also have with us Carol Coronis, the Steel Queen from Portsmouth, New Hampshire. Peter Whitehead will be on the drums, and Ray Hemmer will be on the bass. We're going to offer up some Acadian Celt fiddle tunes that are indigenous to the Northeast region and also across the pond, as well as some maritime music that is also from the Northeast region. We hope you enjoy. Couple tunes. We call this the Whiskey Set. The first tune is called Whiskey Before Breakfast. It has its Irish roots. Followed by Patty on the Railroad, which is another Irish tune. Followed by a tune that we've been playing for years. We don't even have a name for it. And then we end with a French-Canadian tune called the St. Anne's Reel. And it goes something like this. Thank you.
And we have here Steel Queen and Crazy Maggy mixed. And we're doing this Acadian Celt American roots stuff for you. On the drums, we have Mr. Peter Whitehead. We have the Steel Queen herself, Carol Coronis, and Ray Himmer on the bass. And my name's EJ Ouellette, and this is a tune about my hometown of Haverhill, Massachusetts. It's called Shoe City.
Tracks of my daddy's ways. I stopped, listened to the sounds of this word of town. It was no one around the world back then. How could it be that it was my friend when I saw those broken buildings that once thrived? I still see the old man round Libro's bar, placing the bets with the guys in the car. In the bag, Lady Grace is gone. Who will carry on? I could feel it in the air, from the river to the square. There's a heart still here. Shoe City, Shoe City, Shoe City. There's that big old river that stretches to the north, the lifeblood of the region, the well that brought forth my grandma. She lived down in Phoenix Road. In that same red building that she used to stitch leather, their rich old men and made them richer. The pennies that she made never turned to gold. You know the old man. And bent, and now it goes somewhere. And a girl I once knew wouldn't stay. She came to school from far away. I could feel it in the air, from the river to the square. There's a heart still here in Shoe City, in Shoe City.
how are you? My name is Triana. I'm from Mexico, and I'm so happy to be part of the beautiful Multicultural Festival in Haverhill. So today, we're gonna cook a very traditional Mexican dish, very delicious, name it frijoles charros, charro bean. Maybe you guys already heard about this wonderful dish, and now you guys gonna learn how to prepare. Hi guys, here we are. I'm Triana, and now we're gonna cook this very traditional and delicious Mexican dish named charro bean, frijoles charros. We're gonna need 2 cups of ham, any kind of ham. If you prefer turkey ham, it's much better, more healthy. So bacon, 2 cups of bacon, 2 cups of sausage, any kind of you like it. 1 cup of red bell pepper, 1 cup of green bell pepper, 1 cup of diced tomato, 1 cup of onion, and 2 garlic cloves. And the main ingredient, guys, is the beans. You can cook as well, but also you can use the beans that come already cooked in a can. So anything that you guys use, you're gonna have the same result, a very delicious beans. So now let's go to the stove. The first ingredient that you guys are gonna put on the pan is the bacon, because we need something greasy to cook the other ingredients. And I think this thing is greasy enough. In Mexico, we used to have a different one, but here is what we found, and I think it's very similar to Mexican bacon flavor. Next ingredient is our delicious garlic, garlic cloves. So remember, guys, 2 garlic cloves. This is gonna be the flavor of our charro beans. I wish that you guys can smell. Smell really good. My grandma showed me how to prepare this delicious dish. Next ingredient is the 1 cup of onions. Now the flavor and the smell are increased. This is super easy dish, guys. And trust me, your family are gonna be so happy to try it. Next one is the red pepper. Green pepper. And our cup of diced tomatoes. It smells really good. If you guys prepare this dish, you don't gonna need anything else. Just maybe a white rice, and that's all. It's a very complete meal. You have the protein, the vegetables, and you can add grains if you cook the rice. You guys can cook this thing at least for 5 minutes, and then you can add the ham, your favorite one, the sausage, if you guys want, you can add salt. But trust me, you guys don't need it, because the bacon, ham, and sausage are already very good in flavor. So, but if you guys want, you guys can add a little bit of salt. Or instead of salt, you guys can add a little bit of chicken bouillon powder. After this process, you guys need to have another pot. That is where all the flavors are going to explode. Now our main ingredient, guys, the beans. You guys can, now I'm using pink beans, but you guys can use any kind of beans, except black, because then, you know, you can use it, but it's not like the main bean that you can use with this dish, this kind of dish. But any beans that you have at home are gonna work very well. And now, 2 cups of water and 1/2 spoon of chicken bouillon in powder. This is optional. You guys can use it or not. But I like it because it gives that extra flavor. If my grandma can see me, I'm sure she's gonna be so happy to see that I'm cooking one of the dish, one of her dishes, one of the most favorite dishes. You guys want to see it? Look, the beautiful color of the vegetables, the beans, the meat. And trust me, guys, this thing smell really good. So you can prepare for your family anytime, you know. Sunday, for example, if you have a, you want to get it with your family, can be a very delicious dish, very simple, inexpensive. And trust me, everybody's gonna be so happy to try it. You guys can cook this thing just for 10 or 15 minutes. It's basically ready if you guys have the beans ready. So just 10 or 15 minutes and that's all. You guys can enjoy the charro beans.
Hi you guys, my name is Brianna and this is my dad Finchley. We are so proud of our Haitian culture.
Hi, my name is Finchley. This is my daughter Brianna. I'm very, very proud of my culture where I came from to in Haiti. I remember when I was growing up, my grandma, she always make the best Haitian food ever.
Yeah, my grandma makes the best bouillon. Y'all gotta try it. I don't know what it's called in English, but y'all gotta try it.
In English, they call it dirty water, but it's very, 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 very good. So me and my wife, we own a restaurant in downtown Haverhill called Triana with Mexican food. And then we're very proud of the Haverhill community. They welcome us here. So
we want to Everybody is very, very nice here. Very nice. Very nice.
Okay. Another tune. This one we call Norista. So it's a mixture of French Canadian, Cajun, reggae, and Irish and Scottish. It's called Norista.
Thank you. Hi, everybody. My name is Nury Cardoza, and I'm from the Dominican Republic, Santo Domingo, the capital. My family is a huge family. My grandparents had 22 kids, and Christmas was just a huge celebration. Everybody used to go to my grandma's house. All the cousins, the aunts, aunties were there, and it was just a fabulous time. Right now, to celebrate and reunite the family, we had family reunions. And we are so many members that we had to do it in a resort. The family right now, without counting the last generation, is almost 400 members, and we all have the same last name. Everybody flies into the island, and we had a big celebration every 2 years. That is my story.
We got love, love, love. You better believe it. We got love, love, love. You better believe it.
In the carriage, yeah. I got black love and marriage, yeah. They gon' say you can't have it, but I'm like, don't kill the messenger. We gon' break the stigma up. Huxtables turn to Obamas. It ain't about where you been, where you from. What you got is all about love. Self-love is the best love. When you go take that wristband off, that petite party bent over. Don't need makeup to dress you up. I gave birth on the bathroom floor. Just me, Iman, and headphone calls. Don't let this life defeat you. I hope this message reach you. Throw your hands up. Play catch with the hunnids. Love is the new money. I'm just chillin' with the homies, homies where the heart is. Throw your hands up. Play catch with the hunnids. Love is the new money. I'm just chillin' with the homies, homies where the
we
heart
got
is.
Love, love, love. You better believe it.
Love.
We got love, love, love. You better believe it.
Play catch with the hunnids. Love is the new money. I'm just chillin' with the homies. Homies where the heart is. Ah. Play catch with the hunnids. Love is the new money. I'm just chillin' with the homies. Homies where the heart is. Ah.
Above all, you keep your clarity. You keep your focus. You keep your sense of love. And you keep your sense of purpose. Those are... they're integral, you know, they're key. Happiness, you know. A lot of people define success differently. You know, for me, you can have everything. You can have all the money in the world. But if it's not enjoyable, if it's not sustainable, you know, if you can't be a person of integrity while having all these things, what does it matter? What does it mean? Your value is internal. Your value is internal.
We got love, love, love. You better believe it. We got love, love, love. You better believe it.
We want to thank you so much for tuning into the Multicultural Festival of 2021. This is truly a celebration of many cultures that represent the spectacular residents of Haverhill, Massachusetts. It is the first of what we hope will turn into an annual event where we can continue to experience Haverhill and all of its wonderful cultures that it represents. Until next year. This event is funded in part by the Haverhill Cultural Council, which is a local agency funded by the Massachusetts Cultural Council, a state agency. Are you looking to join the Haverhill Cultural Council? It's open to any resident of the city of Haverhill over 18 that would like to be more involved within the community. Email us at haverhill.grants@gmail.com and we can provide you with more information on how to join.